Students, so today we will complete this portion, experiments on seed germination. Some part I have explained to you in the morning, so I am repeating this part again to understand in a better way. So germination of seeds, you have studied in the first two parts, that what is the germination and the types of seeds, monocot and dicot seed. Now today we will study what are the key factors for the germinations. These factors are very essential for the growth of seedling from the seed. Because what is germination? So the germination is the process of formation of seedling from the seed. So you'll see here what are the factors required: water, light, temperature, oxygen, food, and the time is also. Water is needed to begin the process, and then for the growth I explained you in detail what is the need of the water, and it is needed for the metabolic activity. And light is also needed. So presence or absence of light, it depends on the species to which the seed belong. So this amount of light, its presence or absence, it depends upon the different species to which the seed belong. Temperature, so temperature also I taught to you already, that very high or very cold temperature is not suitable for the development of the seedling. Then the oxygen, yes, it is must, it is needed for the respiration. Without that, respiration cannot take place, and the seed that which is developing into the seedling cannot get the energy. So it is the source of energy. This respiration is the source of energy. Food, yes, the food which is stored in cotyledons or endosperm, it provides energy. It undergoes oxidation actually with the help of oxygen and provide energy. Time, yes, it depends on the species. So first experiment to prove that water is necessary for seed germination. So here what we will do, we will take two beakers, beaker A and beaker B, and in beaker A we will place the dry cotton wool, and beaker B we are going to place wet cotton wool. So cotton wool lenge, yahan par dry and here it is wet, and then we will place some of the seeds on dry cotton wool in the beaker A and some equal amount of that seed on the wet cotton wool. Now we'll keep the setup as it is for the 2 days at the normal temperature and the light, and then what shall we see there? That there is no germination take place in the seeds which are placed in the beaker A, while the germination starts in the seeds of the beaker B. What is the reason? The reason is very clear here. You can see the cause, that here none of the water available for the germination. So no germination is observed by us in the beaker A, while the germination has started in the beaker B. So what we conclude? We conclude that the water is needed for the germination of seed. This is a simple experiment. You also can do it home. Now here it is the link here to prove that the water necessary for the germination. So you click on this link and watch the video. In this video, this experiment is shown. Now next, the that to show that the optimum temperature is necessary for seed germination. So what we will do when the we are saying the optimum temperature is needed, so for that we are placing the seeds at two different temperature. One more temperature we can take in the beaker C. Here beaker A and B only shown, we can take one more beaker for the high temperature. So in beaker A, what we are doing, the temperature which is maintained is very low by placing the ice cube. So हम ice cubes रखेंगे box के अंदर, तो वहाँ वो temperature को low कर देगा, and then we will place the beaker along with the seed. In beaker B, we are placing the wet cotton wool only, and then the seeds we are placing over here. Then the beaker C we will take and will place the seeds, and will keep this beaker C in the hot oven at a particular temperature by setting it, and now allow all these beaker for the further experiment, means for the growth of seed, for 2 to 3 days. Now what we will observe there, definitely here the beaker A which is placed at very low temperature and beaker C which we are placing at high temperature, there will be no germination in the seed. So seeds will be non-germinated. But we found germinated seeds in the beaker B. Why? Because here the wet cotton wool as well as this beaker is placed at the room temperature. So the temperature which is optimum suitable for the growth. So suitable for the germination. So germination has taken in the that beaker B. So what is proved here? That the optimum temperature is required for the germination of seed. Again, here a link is for you. So see this experiment also. Now, to show that oxygen is necessary for seed germination. So for this, what shall we do? Here, we'll take two flasks. This is conical flask, and in this flask again, we will place some soaked seed, equal amount of soaked seed, and then we'll take two test tubes. And in one of the test tube which we are going to place in flask A, we will fill it with pyrogallic acid. And in the flask B, we will fill with the water. This test tube is filled with the water. So we'll label it as test tube A and this is at test tube B. Now, this test tube A and B both are tied with the help of thread and hanged in the flask. After hanging it, we will close this that mouth of the flask with the help of cork, so making it airtight, so no air can enter into it. Now keeping this setup again for 2 to 3 days, and we will observe there that there is a germination taking place in the flask B in the seeds, but no germination in the seeds placed in the flask A. What is the reason? So reason is there, this pyrogallic acid which absorbs oxygen being very reactive. So it absorbs the oxygen there and show its chemical reaction with the oxygen. So no oxygen is available for these seeds which are placed here in the flask A. So germination is not taking place. Here the seeds, they are getting oxygen, and the water, you know, that does not show any that reactivity. It is normal neutral water, so does not show any reactivity and no impact. So whatever oxygen was available here was utilized by these seeds in the process of germination. So we are observing here the germinated seeds. So it proves that oxygen is necessary for the seed germination. Again, here it is a link for you. So click over here and see the video. Now to show that adequate water temperature and oxygen are necessary for seed germination. So here we are studying all three factors together. Ek saath adequate water temperature or oxygen. Hum teenon factors ko ek saath study karenge. And this is known as the three bean experiment also. So what we are doing here? We are taking three seeds, bean seeds. Three bean seeds we are taking, and we are tying these seeds with the help of thread in such a way that these seeds, when they are placed on these slides in the water, the top seed is in air, the middle seed is at the level of water, and this last seed, lower seed, is completely inside the water. So in tino bean seeds ko hum thread ki help se tie karke slide ke upar slide ko is tarike se rakhenge beaker ke pani mein ki jo beaker ke andar jo first seed hai, that will be in air, the middle seed at the level of water, partially in water, and the third seed, it is in the water. So we'll label it seed A, seed B and seed C. Then we'll leave this experimental setup as it is. And 2 to 3 days again we will observe. So what we will observe, that there is germination started in the middle seed, or what we call it as the B seed. There is no germination in A seed, no germination in the little germination starts in the C seed. What is the reason? So let we start it from the first seed, non-germinated seed, because this seed is getting air but does not get the water. Water is required for the germination. So there is no germination. Oxygen is available. Here this seed B or the middle seed is getting sufficient water, oxygen and the temperature too. So this seed is undergoing germination, and you will see the developing roots and the shoot part. Seed C, it develops little there, develops the radical, because getting the water, oxygen availability is not there, though the water has the dissolved oxygen, but that is not sufficient for the germination. So little germination starts here, then you'll see the small radical, and after that the growth stops. So it is slightly germinated, say. So what it proves, that adequate water, temperature and oxygen are necessary for seed germination. So students, we have completed this chapter. Now you solve the back exercises of this chapter and the middle also, because in the next part we will start the respiration in plants. And ask your doubts regularly. Ask your doubts in the Google Classroom or in that WhatsApp group also we have. You can ask your doubts there also. So, thank you, children.